Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss the inverse of a square matrix. Our example will be to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix. We have the matrix A, whose entries are 1, negative 2, negative 3, 1, 0, 2, and negative 1, 1, and 0. Let's go ahead and carefully find the inverse. So step one is to write the following. So you write a parentheses, and you take your 3x3 matrix and you write it like this. 1, negative 2, negative 3, 1, 0, 2, negative 1, 1, 0. And then you write a line. And right here what you do is you write the 3x3 identity matrix, which is just 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. So just copying down your matrix here and then over here inserting this identity matrix. The goal is to make your matrix, what we put here, look like what's over here on the right. So we want to turn this into the identity matrix, and we do it one column at a time, okay? So the first step is to make this a 1, which it already is, and then we make these numbers below it 0. Then we make this number here in the middle a 1, and we make the numbers above it 0s, and then we make the bottom number here a 1, and we make the numbers above it 0s. So we do one column at a time. I'm going to write down what we're doing before we do it so it helps us with the computations. So to eliminate this 1 in the second row, we're going to multiply the first row by negative 1 and add it to the second row. And then to eliminate the negative 1 in the third row, we're going to add the first row to the third row. So parentheses. I'm going to copy down that first row again. So 1, negative 2, negative 3. Draw the line, 1, 0, 0. By the way, these take a lot of practice to get good at because it's very easy to make a mistake. So if you're working through these and you're feeling frustrated, it's okay. It just takes practice. So negative 1 times row 1 plus row 2. But we're doing that now in our head, okay? So negative 1 plus 1 is 0. 2, it's really a 2, right? Because it's being multiplied by negative 1. 2 plus 0 is 2. 3 plus 2 is 5, right? It's really a 3. Negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Really quickly, I'll go over it again. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0, checks. 2 plus 0, 2. 3 plus 2 is 5. Negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. The last one, we just have to add row 1 to row 3. So 1 plus negative 1 is 0. Very good. See, we have that first column now. Negative 2 plus 1 is negative 1. 3 plus negative 3 plus 0 is negative 3. See, I almost messed up. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. It's a lot of mental computations, right? Lots of brain power. Let's keep going. Now we have to make this number here, this 2 has to turn into a 1. But to do that, what we're going to do is we're going to basically multiply the second row by 1/2. And that's the only thing we're going to do in this next step. So I'm just going to write a little arrow here. I'll write 1/2 R2. And we're just keeping the first and third rows the same. So we have 1, negative 2, negative 3, the line, 1, 0, 0. And then multiplying the second row by 1/2, it's going to give us 0, 1, 5/2, negative 1/2, 1/2, and 0. Again, just dividing everything by 2, right? So you get 1, 5/2, negative 1/2, 1/2, and then 0. And then we keep that third row just like it is. All right, now this is a harder step. We have to make the numbers above this 1. We have to make the numbers above the 1 and below the 1 zeros. So we're going to do, make the negative 2 a 0. We're going to do 2 times row 2 plus row 1. And then we're going to do row 2 plus row 3 to make that last row negative 1 a 0, to make this 1 a 0, right? We do row 2 plus row 3. All right, writing the parentheses down. So we can't write down the first row because we're changing it. So we're doing 2 times row 2 plus row 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So we're doing the computation. 2 plus negative 2 is 0. 2 times 5/2 is 5. 5 plus negative 3 is 2. 2 times negative 1 half is negative 1. Negative 1 plus 1 is 0. 2 times 1 half is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. We keep the second row. 0, 1, 5 halves. Negative 1 half, 1 half, 0. And then we add row 2 to row 3. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus negative 1 is 0. 5 halves plus 3 is really 5 halves minus 6 halves, which is minus 1 half. Negative 1 half plus 1 is 1 half. 1 half plus 0 is 1 half. 0 plus 1 is 1. Again, 5 halves minus 3 is 5 halves minus 6 halves, which is minus 1 half. That one's a little bit tricky. So look at that. Second column is done. Now we have to make this number here a 1. So we can multiply the entire row there by negative 2 in order to accomplish that. So we're going to do negative 2 times row 3 now. So we can write down the first row. So we have 1, 0, 2. Draw the line 0, 1, 0. And we can write down the second row, 0, 1, 5 halves, negative 1 half, 1 half, 0. And now we're multiplying that bottom row by negative 2. So these two are just going to be 0. Negative 2 times negative 1 half is 1. And this is going to be negative 1, negative 1, and then negative 2, right? Just multiplying each of these by negative 2. And that's what we'll get. So now, this is the last step. We need to make the numbers above this 1, these numbers here that I've circled, we need to make these zeros. So to make the 2 a 0, we're going to do negative 2 times row 3 plus row 1. And to make the 5 halves a 0, we're going to do negative 5 halves times row 3 plus row 2. This is a harder example, by the way. This is not the easiest problem. I pick one that's, this is, let's say, medium slash hard. All right, negative 2 times row 3 plus row 1. Let's do that. So 0 plus 1 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Negative 2 plus 2 is 0. Right, we're multiplying negative 2 times row 3, adding it to row 1. 2 plus 0 is 2. Right, it's really a 2, right? Because it's negative 2 times negative 1. 2 plus 1 is 3. Okay. 4 plus 0 is 4. And then we do negative 5 halves times row 3 plus row 2. So 0 plus 0 is 0. That part's easy. 0 plus 1 is 1. Negative 5 halves plus 5 halves is 0. That was the whole point. 5 halves minus 1 half is 4 halves, which is 2. 5 halves plus 1 half is 6 halves, which is 3. Negative 5 halves times negative 2 is simply going to be, so if you do negative 5 halves times negative 2, you're just going to get 5. This is going to be 5 right here, right? Multiplying the negative 2 by negative 5 halves. And then we keep the bottom row, 0, 0, 1, negative 1, negative 1, negative 2. You saw how I did that. I went to the side and did that computation. Whenever you feel like, oh, you're not really sure, you just get a little confused, go to the side and do the computation, right? I did a lot of this in my head. Eventually, you want to do all of it in your head. And then, so the inverse is what's left there. A inverse is going to be the matrix with entries 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 5, negative 1, negative 1, negative 2. Really awesome. Really, really tough problem. So as you can see, this problem takes a ton of work. And that's unfortunately how it is for these problems. They just take a lot of practice. But once you can do one or two of these on your own and you get the feel for it, you do get better at it. But it's really easy to make mistakes. Hopefully, this video has helped you get a little bit better at finding the inverse of a square matrix. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.